Costs are assigned to the cost object either by tracing the cost to the cost object if the costs were direct, or by allocating the cost to the cost object if the costs were indirect. There are several factors that affect the direct-indirect cost classification. First, the materiality of the cost. Immaterial costs are classified as indirect costs because you cannot trace them to the cost object. It would not be cost beneficial to spend efforts and time to trace, for example, the amount of lubricants used when assembling each car. In this case, it would be better to use an allocation base to calculate the share of each car from the lubricants used. Steel used in producing a car is a material cost and is classified as a direct cost to the car, because it can be traced to the produced car easily. Another factor is the layout of the production facilities. If a facility is designed to produce more than one model of cars, then the rent of the facility is an indirect cost to these car models, as you cannot trace the rent cost to each model of the cars produced. You have to figure out an allocation base, like for example the area of the facility used to produce each car model, to calculate the share of each car model from the facility rental cost. But if the facility is designed to produce only one car model, then the rent of the facility in this case is easily traceable to that only car model, and is therefore a direct cost to that car model. The nature of the cost object is one of the factors. The cost object can be a product, a department, an activity, or any other object for which a cost measurement is needed. The rent of the facility is an indirect cost if the cost object is the various car models produced by the facility, but is a direct cost to the facility itself if the production facility is the cost object. Note that the level of technology implemented in some production facilities made it easier to trace most of the indirect costs to cost objects, and thus converted most of the indirect costs to direct ones.